Good afternoon. We're so very pleased to welcome you again. For those who may be just joining us, my name is Ryan Price, the senior pastor here, and just delighted again once more to have the opportunity and honor to host this Brite Ministry Week this week here at Broadway. We welcome you each and all, and are particularly excited about this concert this afternoon. I have been joking with Janet Pummel that she orchestrated this whole thing to be able to play the Clyburn organ this whole week. So we're very excited that we've had the joy of hearing this magnificent instrument played so beautifully thus far, and particularly excited about this concert this afternoon. It is my honor and privilege to welcome and introduce to you a good Broadway friend, and that is Dr. Emmett Smith, Professor Emeritus at TCU, and as I say, someone who is not only a friend of yours, but truly a friend of Broadway's as well, and we welcome you.
Years before Jesus was born, the first pipe organ was built. It was designed and built by a Greek engineer whose name was Ctesibius. And pipe organs were used in the Colosseums. When the Christians were eaten by the lions, they had organ music to accompany it. And the reason we know all this is because it was printed on graveyard stones that here lies Betty Jean Jones. She was whoever was the head person in the Roman government because she played the best in the Colosseums. So that was way back 250 before Christ, and then it entered the church in 800 AD, and Charlemagne, Charles the Great, spread the organ through all of the Roman Catholic churches that he could in the Holy Roman Empire because he liked it, and the organ was a gift from the Byzantine government in North Africa. And Charlemagne had it all taken apart, copied, and ministers who knew how to be good carpenters. And so they built the organs for the churches, and that was in 800. So the voice of the church became truly the church's musical voice in 800, and it still is. We like to dream that it is. And you're going to hear an organist today who is quite different from some of the finest, famous organists you can possibly go to hear. It's because he has a special talent to go to any organ and know how to combine the use of the various stops. And a stop is you pull it out to make it play. So it's really, you're not stopping, you're starting. And you push it away and you're stopping. But he knows how to combine them to make the organ have many colorful voices that you will be so pleased to hear. And he has chosen a recital program that is not burdened down with 15 or 20 minute long pieces. This is full of melodies and beautiful sounds, and it gives me true pleasure to introduce to you Patrick Scott.
Thank you all for being here this afternoon and for coming back from what's hope has been a wonderful conference for you all for Ministry Week. This is my second time playing for Ministry Week. The last was probably over 10 years ago over at UCC, but it's a pain to be here to play this beautiful instrument today. So I'm happy to be here. You get to be involved with this concert, and so we've got a couple of hymns picked out that I'll ask for you to sing, and then I'll play an arrangement based on some of those hymns. So the first one is Alleluia, Sing to Jesus, page 263 in your hymnal. Feel free on any of these hymns to sing parts on the inner verses. So if you sing alto, tenor, or bass, or if you just want to make your own part up, it doesn't matter to me. But we'll sing this, and why don't you stand? We all sing better when we stand.
Thank you.
You're all hired. That was wonderful. I forgot to mention that the setting of Hyfrydol that I'm going to play is by Al Travis, who is, of course, no stranger to Broadway. He was organist here for many, many years. And so this is his setting of Hyfrydol.
Thank you.
One of the beauties of an organ like this is not only the power that can come out of it, but also the soft and beautiful stops. And this next piece really shows off the many flute stops of the organ. It's called the Musical Clocks. It's by Haydn. And back in Haydn's time, we didn't have the luxury of having a watch on our arm or our cell phone or almost anything to tell us the time. We had to wait until a cuckoo clock or something would go off for you to know what hour it was. And if you had enough money, someone like Haydn could write you little tunes that would go on the hour instead of a cuckoo clock. And so these were some of the things that might have sounded on the hour. Haydn wrote many of these. This is just a few of them. Because we have the luxury of this beautiful organ, I've tried to not use the same flute twice in both the back organ and the front organ. So every time you hear a new flute, it is not one that you've heard before. So that's a really cool thing about having an organ of this size. Following that is a great piece by Louis Vierne, a big French composer, was organist at Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. And the story is told that he was given the notes of the Big Ben Westminster Carillon to write this tune. You will know it right off. Bum, 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 bum. And the whole piece is based off that. How he manages to write a whole piece on it, we'll find out, but it's a great piece. So first the clock pieces, and then the bell pieces.
Thank you.
I'm excited to share these next two pieces with you by Florence Price. Florence Price is famous because she was the first African-American woman to have a major piece performed by a major symphony orchestra many, many years ago. But she was also a fabulous pianist and an organist and wrote a lot of music for not only orchestra, but piano and organ. She was born in Little Rock, Arkansas, but spent most of her life in Chicago. And just a few years ago, maybe 10 or 15 years ago, there was a second home of hers that people had forgotten existed or didn't know existed. And in that home were found a multitude of new works. Some of those are these organ works, which these two pieces are part of. The best word for them is charming. You will smile when you hear them, and they use some stops of the organ that we may not normally get to hear. The offertory gets to use the harp of the organ. Believe it or not, the organ does actually have everything but the kitchen sink, including a harp, so we'll get to hear that. And then the first piece is Allegretto, and it's the one that you should smile through.
Thank you.
We'll sing another hymn next, and based on that hymn, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name, we'll hear some variations by Gerre Hancock, who I was lucky to be able to study with at the University of Texas at Austin when I was in graduate school, where I worked at University Christian Church with Mary Lou Johnston and some wonderful people, including Bill Haley, who was a student with Mary Lou, not at the same time, different times, with Emmett Smith. So that's one reason I'm here today, because of those wonderful people and the wonderful church that is the Disciples Church. And so that piece by Gerre Hancock. After that, you'll hear something on the organ you don't normally hear, which is Clair de Lune. You've heard it on the piano a million times, whether in person or in movies. It is one of the most famous pieces, but it sounds just as good on the organ, I promise. And then after that will be Solemn Melody by Walford Davies, which is a beautiful piece that starts and ends very quietly and has a magnificent build in the middle. But first, let's stand and sing hymn 95, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. We'll close with a great hymn, one of my favorites, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, hymn number 45, and then I will do an improvisation based on that theme and whatever else comes to my brain. Thank you for coming this afternoon. It's been a joy to play and to be in this space and to be a part of Ministry Week once again. And from a musician to a bunch of clergy colleagues, we appreciate you, even though it may not seem like it sometimes. But we're so grateful for wonderful clergy and for people who devote their time to a week like this to engage and learn. And on behalf of all organists and musicians everywhere, thank you. But personally, thank you for coming this afternoon, and let's stand and sing this final hymn, hymn 45.